students, in previous session we had discussed about chapter 14, that is water. We had discussed about sources of water, water cycle, different states of water and extremes of rainfall. So now in today's session we will discuss about chapter 15 of your science textbook, that is air around us. So first of all, let's take a view on the topics that we will discuss here. So in this chapter, you will learn about air. Is air present everywhere around us? What is air made up of? How does oxygen become available to animals and plants living in water and soil? How is the oxygen in atmosphere replaced? Uses of air and air pollution. So starting with introduction. Air is a mixture of several gases. We cannot see or smell air, but air is everywhere around us. All living things require air. Air is inside the human body as well as in the bodies of other animals and birds. This is because air is necessary for breathing of all the living things. So no living things can survive without air. Even we can live without food and water for few days, but we cannot live for more than a few minutes without air. Air is present on ground, on the top of the trees and buildings, as well as high up in the sky. Air is present in the soil. Some air is present even in the water of ponds, lakes, rivers and oceans in dissolved form. So though we cannot see air, but we can feel its presence when it starts moving. So moving air is called wind. Moving air makes the clothes hanging on the clothesline sway, and the air blowing in the garden stairs, the leaves and branches of the trees. When a fan is switched on, the air moves the blades of the fan, makes the pages of an open book flutter back and forth. It is the moving air which makes it possible for us to fly a kite in the sky. And it is also the moving air which pushes the sails of yacht, that sailing boat, and make it move in the water. We have seen the many little children playing with firki. This is the diagram of firki, wind vane. When the child holds the stick of firki on its hand, stand in an open area and adjust the direction of firki blade, then the firki start rotating. It is the moving air which makes the firki rotate. Okay. So about the air. Air is transparent, so we cannot see through it. Air fills all the spaces available to it. Since the air is a gaseous substance, it can be compressed easily. When we fill a football bladder or a bicycle tube with air by using a pump, we actually compress the air. So some properties of air is that air is colorless, tasteless and odorless gaseous substance. Air has mass, air occupies space, air dissolves in water and air can be compressed. See, this is a diagram of weathercock. It shows the direction in which the air is moving. And how this happens? See, in weathercock, a broad blade in the shape of cock is fixed on an arrow which is attached to the rotating axis. And when the moving air pushes the cock blade, then the cock and its arrow rotate and align the direction of the moving air. Thus, the weathercock is a device which shows the direction in which the air is moving at a place. Okay? See, air is present everywhere around us. Though it cannot be seen by us, even those containers or vessels which appear to be empty to us are filled with air. For example, an empty bottle is not really empty. It contains air in it. Even when we turn an empty bottle upside down, द एयर रिमेन्स इन इट. वी कैन शो बाय परफॉर्मिंग अ सिंपल एक्टिविटी दैट एयर ऑक्यूपाई स्पेस एंड दैट इवन इन एम्प्टी बॉटल दैट इज फुल ऑफ एयर. सी, टेक द एम्प्टी ग्लास बॉटल एंड होल्ड इट इन इनवर्टेड पोजिशन, मीन्स एज इट माउथ इज फेसिंग डाउनवर्ड. Now the inverted glass bottle is put in the water kept in the vessel. We observe that the water does not enter into the inverted glass bottle because it is filled with air. Now tilt the glass bottle, held the water. We will find that the air present in the glass bottle goes out in the form of air bubbles. So as the air from the glass bottle escape, the water start entering the glass bottle. Now the space vacated by the air leaving the bottle is now occupied by water. So this activity shows that the glass bottle, which appears to be empty, is actually filled with air. Now about atmosphere. Our Earth is surrounded by a layer of air, means envelope of air, and the envelope of air that surround the earth is called atmosphere. The atmosphere is essential for life on earth. Why? This is because the air of atmosphere provide oxygen gas for breathing by all the living organism including us. And as we go higher up in the atmosphere, the amount of air becomes less and less, and the air at the top of the high mountain is so thin that it does not have enough oxygen for people to breathe properly. So the people who climb high mountains carry cylinder oxygen gas with them. They breathe in oxygen from these cylinders. Okay? Now, what is air made of? As we know that air is a gas, for a long time people thought that air was just a single gas. It has now been proved by experiment that air is not a single gas. Air is a mixture of many gases. The major component of air is nitrogen gas, that is 78%. The second major component of the oxygen component of air is oxygen gas, that is 21%. Okay, so the nitrogen and oxygen gases taken together make up about 99% of air, and the remaining 1% of air consists of carbon dioxide, water vapor, and few other gases and some dust particles. Okay, so this is the composition of air, that nitrogen 78%, oxygen 21%, carbon dioxide 0.03%, gases, other gases 0.90%, and water vapor based or dust or impurities in variable amount. Variable amount means the composition of air is not always exactly the same. It changes slightly from place to place and season to season. For example, the air over industrial cities usually has a higher amount of carbon dioxide. The air in the coastal areas have more water vapor in comparison to inland areas. The air also contains more water vapor in rainy season. Similarly, the amount of dust in the air is more in windy places than the other areas. So its composition changes with place to place and season to season. Now, I will show you one activity that shows the presence of oxygen. See, for this, you need water, throw candle and gas jar. Now take the candle, place it in the throw, that container. Now fill it with water. Light the candle and inverted gas jar over the candle. then what will happen? After some time, the candle gets extinguished because of the oxygen is used up. So what does it mean? When the oxygen inside the gas jar is used up, the candle is extinguished. Also, the space occupied by the oxygen inside the inverted glass becomes empty. The water rises up to occupy this space. And the major part of the air left is nitrogen. Okay? So, this activity show the presence of oxygen and nitrogen in air. Now, about nitrogen. See, this is the symbol of nitrogen, N, and its atomic number is 7. That's why it is written N7. Nitrogen is colorless, tasteless, and odorless gas. It is slightly soluble in water and it is not essential for breathing. And neither burns itself or supports the burning. But all living things need nitrogen compounds for their growth. The plant uses nitrogen gas to make the for the air to make protein. These protein are used by the plant for their own growth as well as for the growth of human beings and other animals. Does the nitrogen is needed by plants to make protein? Okay. Second one is about oxygen. Oxygen is colorless, tasteless, and odorless gas. Oxygen gas does not burn itself, but it allows other things to burn. Means it supports for burning. It is a supporter of burning. This activity shows that when we cover the candle, that previous activity, when we covered the candle with the glass jar, due to the absence of oxygen, that stops burning. Okay? So everything burns only in the presence of oxygen. So oxygen is necessary for the process of burning, means combustion of fuels like wood, coal, kerosene, petrol. It supports life and combustion. And we need oxygen for breathing. Next is about carbon dioxide. This CO2 is the formula of carbon dioxide. It is a colorless and odorless gas and slightly sour in taste. It is moderately soluble in water. That oxygen is also soluble in water. Carbon dioxide gas neither burn nor support burning, but it extinguishes the burning fire. So plants and animals consume oxygen from the air for respiration and produce carbon dioxide. What is the use of carbon dioxide for green plants? They need carbon dioxide to make food. And all the food which animals eat is made from carbon dioxide gas of the air. Okay? Next is about water vapor. Air also contains water vapor. We cannot see that water vapor present in air, but it is the water in the form of gas. The water vapor present in it condenses to form tiny droplets that later form clouds. So, presence of water vapor in air is important for the working of water cycle in nature. This is because it is the water vapor present in air which rises high in the sky along with the hot air and gets cooled, condensed to form cloud, and that bring rain on the earth. Now, dust particles and smoke. The dust particles come into air from the number of sources like blowing winds, traffic on roads, dusting at home, agriculture practices. The presence of dust particle in air varies from time to time and from place to place. We normally breathe in air through our nose. Why? Why it considered that we have to breathe through our nose, not from mouth? This is because fine hair and mucus are present inside the nose. It prevents the dust particles from entering into our respiratory system. We should never breathe in air through our mouth. This is because if we breathe through our mouth, then the dust particles present in the air may enter our respiratory system and damage our health. Now about smoke. Smoke is produced by the burning of fuels that tall chimneys in factories are installed to take the smoke produced in the factory high up in the air so as to reduce the harmful effects on the grounds. The burning of fuels like petrol, diesel, car, buses, trucks also produces smoke that contain harmful gases. Now, how can you prove that water contains air? Simply, for this you need a beaker, wire gauze, tripod stand, burner and water. Take some water in the beaker. Heat it slowly. Well, before the water begin to boil, look carefully at the inner surface of the beaker. What you will observe? Tiny bubbles appear on the inner surface of the beaker, and these tiny bubbles come from the air dissolved in the water. So that the presence of bubbles prove that the air present in water. Okay? Now air present in soil. Take the lump of dry soil in a beaker. Add water to it and observe it carefully. What you will see? The water displaces the air in the lump of soil which has seen in the form of bubbles. When you put the water in the soil, it releases in the form of bubbles. And this proves that air present in the soil. Okay, next is how oxygen available to animals and plants living in water and soil. First, I will tell you the oxygen becomes available to the animals and plants living in the soil. The animals which live in soil and the plants' root which grow in the soil need oxygen to breathe, and they get this oxygen from the air present in the spaces between the soil particles. So the animal which live inside the soil get oxygen for breathing from the air present in between the soil particles. For example, earthworm. Earthworm come out of the soil only during heavy rains. Why? Because during the heavy rains, all the spaces in soil which contain air that filled with rainwater and leaving no air in the soil for earthworm to breathe in. So due to this, the earthworm have to come out of the soil to obtain air for breathing. Okay, now about the oxygen available to the animals and plants living in water. First, the animals that live in water are called aquatic animals, and the plant which live in water are called aquatic plants. So aquatic animals and plants live in water of ponds, lake, river, seas. And the water of ponds, lake, river, seas has dissolved air in it. So the animals and plants which live in water use the air dissolved in water for breathing. Since air contains oxygen, so the animals and plants, they get the dissolved oxygen from the water for respiration. Clear? That aquatic plants and animals get the dissolved oxygen from the water, and for the plants and animals that live in soil, they get the oxygen from the spaces between the soil particles that contain air. Next is, हाउ ऑक्सीजन इन एयर रिप्लेस्ड. मीन्स इफ वी कंज्यूम ऑक्सीजन फॉर रेस्पिरेशन, वी कंज्यूम ऑक्सीजन, एनिमल कंज्यूम ऑक्सीजन, दैट एट द सर्टेन कंटेंट ऑफ टाइम इट हैव टू फिनिश, दैट हाउ इट इज बैलेंस इन एटमोसफेयर. द ऑक्सीजन ऑफ एयर बींग कंज्यूम बाई एनिमल्स इन रेस्पिरेशन एंड द बर्निंग ऑफ फ्यूल्स कॉन्स्टेंटली बींग रिप्लेस्ड बाई प्लांट्स थ्रू द प्रोसेस ऑफ फोटोसिंथेसिस. सी इन सनलाइट प्लांट यूज कार्बन डाइऑक्साइड एंड वॉटर टू मेक फूड बाई द प्रोसेस ऑफ फोटोसिंथेसिस एंड प्रोड्यूस ऑक्सीजन गैस एंड दिस ऑक्सीजन कंज्यूम बाई अस मीन्स ह्यूमन्स एंड एनिमल्स एंड वी रिलीज कार्बन डाइऑक्साइड एंड बाय द बर्निंग ऑफ दिस फ्यूल्स दे रिलीज द कार्बन डाइऑक्साइड टू द एटमोसफेयर. So the plant depend on animals for getting carbon dioxide for their photosynthesis and animals depend on plants for the oxygen. So from above discussion we conclude that respiration by animals and plants and burning of fuels by humans uses oxygen and put the carbon dioxide into air. On the other hand, photosynthesis by plants, they uses carbon dioxide from air and put the oxygen back into the air. So in this way the plants and animals help in maintaining the balance of oxygen and carbon dioxide in atmosphere. It shows the interdependence of plants and animals in nature. Clear? Now what are the uses of air? Air is very useful to human beings in many ways. Air is used by human beings for breathing or respiration. Air is used for burning fuels like wood, coal, kerosene. Compressed air is used to fill tires of various kind of vehicles, bicycles, scooters, car, truck, airplanes. Air is also used in inflating balloons and football. Air helps in dispersal of seeds and pollen of flowers of several plants. Blowing air, means wind, is used to turn the blades of the windmill that generate electricity. Air helps in the movement of yacht, means sailing boat, parachutes, airplanes. Air helps the bird, bats, insects in flying. And air plays an important role in water cycling. How? This is because hot air being lighter and rises up and carries the water vapor high up in the sky. And this help in bringing rain. Okay. So these are the uses of air. Now about air pollution. Air is most important for our existence. So when the poisonous gases and harmful substance mix with air, it make it impure and the air is said to be polluted. So the harmful and undesirable substance mixed in air are called pollutants. The air get polluted by smoke, dust, coke emitted by running automobiles, chimneys of industries. And some of the air pollutants that pollute the air are carbon monoxide, carbon dioxide, nitrogen dioxide, sulfur dioxide. These are the air pollutants. They causes air pollution. So what are the causes of air pollution? See, air pollution is caused when the air in the atmosphere get filled with particulate matter, that dust particles. The largest source of air pollution in city is vehicle exhaust fumes. Increase in human pollution, indiscriminate cutting of trees, burning of fossil fuels, using household chemicals without any ventilation, volcanoes, dust storms and forest fire. They are the natural causes of air pollution. Now what are the effects of air pollution? एक्सेस ऑफ कार्बन डाइऑक्साइड कॉजेज सफोकेशन. कार्बन मोनोऑक्साइड दे आर डेडली पॉइजनस एंड दे आर रिलीज फ्रॉम ऑटोमोबाइल्स, एयरक्राफ्ट इंजन, रॉकेट इंजन. दे रिड्यूस द ऑक्सीजन कैरिंग कैपेसिटी ऑफ ब्लड. सल्फर डाइऑक्साइड रिलीज फ्रॉम कोल, इट कॉजेज हेडेक, चेस्ट कॉन्ट्रेक्शन, इरिटेशन इन रेस्पिरेटरी ट्रैक, वॉमिटिंग एक्सेट्रा. एंड नाइट्रोजन डाइऑक्साइड रिलीज फ्रॉम ऑटोमोबाइल्स, इट अफेक्ट्स द रेस्पिरेटरी सिस्टम ऑफ एनिमल्स एंड डिफॉयलेशन लीडिंग टू द डेथ ऑफ सम प्लांट्स. ओके, सो दीज आर द मेजर इफेक्ट्स ऑफ एयर पोल्यूशन. नाउ व्हाट आर द मेथड्स फ्रॉम विच वी कैन रिड्यूस द एयर पोल्यूशन? स्मोक प्रेसिपिटेट शुड बी इंस्टॉल इन द टॉप ऑफ ऑल चिमनीज. लेड फ्री फ्यूल्स मीन्स CNG should be used in automobiles, car, bus, trucks. The vehicles should be subjected to stringent air pollution check. More and more trees should be grown. Industries should be located far away from the residential areas. Use of public transport, carpooling instead of using one own vehicles. Okay, so these are the ways by which we can reduce the air pollution. Clear? So in this chapter, we had seen about the air, that it is the composition of air. It is made up of nitrogen, oxygen, carbon dioxide, some gases, water vapor and dust. They are balanced by the photosynthesis and respiration. We had discussed about the air pollution that cause the harmful substance present in the air. And method of prevention is afforestation, uses of CNG. Check for vehicular emission, use of public transport, and maximum use of 3 RS, that reduce, reuse, and recycle method. Okay, so that's all about this chapter. I hope you all get it very well. Thank you.